Welcome back, Digities. That's right, to another episode of Novadrift, where today we're going to be taking a look at the split shot type of build, where we had a blade weapon, we've had a railgun weapon, we've even had a missile weapon, you know, with missile salvos. But the one thing that we have not taken a look at is honestly just rapid fire. You know, how can you go wrong with just more bullets? You can keep your distance a little bit better, which is, I feel like, a little bit more of my style. So I'm really excited for this type of build. I think this is one that's going to go a lot further. You know, the railgun had its nuances, the blade had its nuances, but the best one that we did the best on was our very first run of even ever playing this game, and that was the missiles. And I feel like the missiles really had a good fighting chance and did the best simply because there were just a lot of it, more bullets. So let's go ahead and take a look at what we have. Shield Halo, a searing hot ring burns nearby enemies. Very nice. Oh yes, I love the red. The red kind of really complements all the blue and purple in the background, so it helps stand out a little bit more. Let's not get slammed immediately. It helps stand out a little bit more to tell where you are. What type of body do we want? A defensive form that has its shield capabilities, a sturdy form with boosted penetrating crash damage and improved recovery, an elusive form of cloaking ability. Ooh. Can I just go ahead and re-roll? Yes, I can. Ooh, a carry, a form that deploys swarm constructs whose behavior depends on the state of your defenses. Fragile construct, focus swarm. I kind of want this. A construct is going to be a little bit better for taking out, or rather spawning a whole bunch of kind of constructs and taking them out of my, like, almost like a carrier, right? It almost is a, it's just a smaller version of our carrier. So I'd love to see exactly how many friends I can get out here. Oh, go ahead and dodge that fireball. Because the idea that I'm going to go for this time is just as how many bullets can I fit on the screen? Make an absolute bullet hell. We already have three different lanes of firing arcs here. On top of that, we want more constructs that'll be firing off on enemies. Just more bullets. What do we have here? I already have an ally and drones. Let's go ahead and take drones. Yep, there we go. Even more bullets on the screen now. And they can go ahead and take out enemies that I'm not looking at. Maybe they'll help take out some people that are out behind me. Loving that they stay almost exactly inside a little red halo ring here. It pleases me. Oh, not, let's not get lasered and lose immediately as I take a whole bunch of damage. I guess it's my fault for standing still too much. Subsumption, assault drones. Convert your drones into assault drones. Rate of fire, drone construct limit. Play drones before they assembled. No, thank you. A turret though. Yes, never mind. Let me get a turret out. A turret is also gonna be a great addition to all this. We already have a couple of drones, so, but a turret is gonna be phenomenal, especially for exactly what we're going for. You can see there in the very top left, exactly on our type of, what do you call it, cooldowns, the E ability there is the construct that automatically deploys, but I have to press W when, ooh, when my turret is completed, so I can go ahead and deploy it whenever I want. Dodge that, thank you. Go ahead and upgrade point defense. Turrets to scale their hull with your level heal you when they're nearby and improve shield effects. That's pretty good, but let's go ahead. Ooh, recursive. Cause there to be a chance for you to spawn one or more swarm constructs when an enemy is destroyed. Hello. I don't know what the chance is. The greater of your maximum hull is destroyed, the greater chance one or multiple swarm constructs are created. Can I just have multiple then? This create, I really want the rate of fire, but can I just have a whole bunch then that end up spawning? I mean, I imagine I can only have like 4 to 5 of them, but maybe it allows you to have more because a whole bunch are dying and creating them. Well, that wasn't much of a mini boss. And look at that, I did spawn 2 of them. Now I got a couple of them flying around for me. Oh, that's amazing. So I can just spawn a whole bunch. Nice. Ooh, took a little bit of damage from the space sperm. Level up. Defiance, regeneration, targeting, magnitude. Projectile size, damage, and blast radius, but I think targeting is going to be pretty nice. I want them to go ahead and start targeting and, like, homing in on the enemies. Defense drones. I don't think I want my drones in a defense drone. Stabilization. Cause global damage to increase as your speed does. I don't really move around as much this time. The ability to stabilize your momentum on command or reverse thrust. Reverse thrust, I think, seems pretty helpful, but I don't use the WASD, so I'm not too sure how that's going to work with, you know, just using the mouse. You know, let's go ahead and actually re-roll. I'm not really liking anything. Cause recursive mobs to be gained in additional time, but reduces your maximum hull shields. Yeah, no thank you. Already hating it. Cause turrets to fire missiles. Ooh. Solar Heart recursive grants burn damage and a flat weapon damage bonus at the cost of constantly taking burn damage. No thank you. Increased burn damage is right there, but I think, you know, let's go ahead and take burn damage simply because The turret is nice, but the turret isn't always out, so I don't necessarily want to put too much into the turret immediately. I want to focus more on being able to defend myself first, because without being able to defend myself, I'll just die quickly. Oh wow, that fired off in 5 different directions. Pretty powerful. I have noticed that some of my constructs are dying pretty quickly, so I might want to do something about keeping them alive longer. Take them out before they even get on screen, almost. Ultra rare mob, Grandir, recursive, causes you to become larger and increases your level. +2 levels, +8% size, crash damage, knockback to targets, and crash damage resistance. Minus thrust, rotation speed. Wild mobs that grant levels will not appear in a random mob pool for your next 2 upgrades. Oh. I mean, yeah, gain 2 levels, just go ahead. I'll be a little bit bigger. If I can go ahead and upgrade again immediately because of that, I can increase the rate of fire, or I can get an ally. I think let's go ahead and get an ally just because of more drones. Now I kind of have everything. So that being said, I should start focusing more on getting actual, like, more weapon damage. And for that being said, projectile size, damage, and blast radius is probably the best way. Banish all mods currently offered to you, grants rerolls and reduces your size. And reduces my size, huh? Even though I just got bigger. +7 rerolls, damn. But no, let's go ahead and get increased projectile size. That seems pretty good. And damage. Nice. Yeah, that's doing a lot more. Because now with just as many bolts as I can, more damage on each of them is going to be pretty beneficial. Look, yeah, I got constructs. I got an ally. I can go ahead and deploy my turret here in a second. There we go. Take out the snake. Take out the snake. Nice. Oh, look at all the drones that spawned from taking out the snakes. Oh, that's amazing. Maybe I should go ahead and try to get the upgrade that allows them to dodge. Point defense, skull through hole, payload. I want the volume, more projectiles, blast radius, and projectile damage, really. Let's see, projectile spread, projectile damage, and burst for your central. Other projectiles also receive adjustments to total projectile damage and blast radius decreasing to 0% for your outmost projectile. No, thank you. I don't like that. I just want to keep everything kind of centered. First contracts hold and assembly speed, payload. Let's just do weapon damage, projectile size, and blast radius again. Yeah, let's just up that. Yeah, the bolts are getting kind of big now. I might want to get some increased targeting if we do get a choice to see that pop up. Charge shot. Allows you to charge your weapon to unleash a more powerful attack. Now, let's your ally dodge enemy attacks. Now, that is exactly what I wanted, because they are taking too much damage out there. They're just running into the enemy. You know, we had all those constructs before, and now they're all gone, too. So, that being said, yeah, we want them to go ahead and avoid some of these. Gain weapon damage, recoil, and rear firing. Note. Primary projectiles to splinter into weaker mini projectiles. Intercept allows your ally to intercept that fires your weapon in addition to its own at a slower rate of fire. Ooh. And or just increase rate of fire. Ah, so many choices. There is so many choices. I think I'm just gonna have to go with rate of fire. Just rate of fire. Because I am doing most of the damage. My constructs are pretty nice, but I am still doing most of the damage. So if I can go ahead and just do more with that, that's going to be a lot better. Yeah, let's go ahead and get projectile velocity and weapon damage. Not bad. Still looking for that increased targeting, which would be pretty nice. That way a lot of these missiles, or not these missiles, a lot of these bullets won't be missing their targets so often. We got the big purple bastard coming in. Let's go ahead and try to take a shot on the inside before he gets a chance to fire off his weapon too much. Which, speaking of which, he's already about to do, is doing. Let's go ahead and avoid getting smacked around too much. Can't quite get a good angle on him. Come on, get inside, take out those. Let's not get slammed around. Okay, let's get out. He's starting to fire off as many bolts as he can. Okay, now get to the other side. Like so. Dodge that as best that you can. Get to the other side again. Come on, just more damage, more damage. There we go. Oh my god, look at this fleet. I just got an achievement called Not the Bees. That is amazing. Upgrade your ally to a garden that recovers a whole of other advanced constructs while nearby. Cause your ally construct to regenerate a hole over time. Yes, I need that right now, considering that I have a shit ton of allies out here. Oh, I guess they don't survive very long because, yeah, they just all instantly disappeared right there. That was amazing. I love how the achievement said not the bees, and I'm also kind of reddish yellow here, too. Nice. You know, I just noticed this background kind of noise. It almost sounds like they just took the recording of a car alarm and said, good enough. It sounds exactly like a car alarm going off. There we go. Makes your ally construct become stronger as you do. Yeah, that sounds pretty good. Not seeing too much. Converse your drones or defense drones. Yeah, just go ahead and make them upgrade as I do. I might want to start taking some stuff for increased like shield or hold damage or, you know, like whole health because homing strike. No, we don't want a single smaller projectile. Interceptor, double tap, adds burst fire and increased rate of fire. Cause your weapon to gain damage, recoil, and refiring. Not very good ones. Reverse your knockback and pulse directions. Not really liking anything. Cause projectiles to deal more damage to targets the further they have traveled. Now that does seem kind of nice, considering that I'm usually firing from a distance. Like so. I'm trying to usually keep my distance from these guys. Ooh, get to the other side. Yeah, already taken out. There we go. Because I am usually trying to keep my distance, that does seem pretty helpful. I thought maybe sniper would have just reduced the projectiles, but nope. Nice. Go ahead and get that XP. Don't let it run away. Take out the ghost snake, which is going to give me a bunch of allies. Beautiful. Yeah, I'm loving this build. Oh, God. A whole bunch of mines just spawn. Dodge the comets. Not really sure what that purple guy was. He's about to rush me, I believe. Yep, there he goes. He's about to come out on the other side somewhere. Nope. He kind of somehow circled back around on me. Ooh, construct hold and assembly speed, guidance, slow projectiles and greatly improved projectile targeting. That's what I was looking for. That's what I wanted. Now look at that. Yeah, sure, it's slower, but they actually all managed to land on their targets. Loving it. Loving it. Which does help a lot too with the snipe mechanic because the further they travel, the more damage they do. Point defense, you know, I forgot that I have a turret. I need to start deploying the turret more. Makes your thrusters launch fireballs that deal burn damage and ignite. Okay, sure, why not? I mean, I'm not, I don't think it really matters much to me, but it's something. Deploy my turret. I can almost just fire in a circle and take everything out for me. Loving it. This is going to be an overpowered run. Oh God, okay, here is the one enemy that I die to way too often. This is the test of the run. If I can take this guy out, then we know that things are gonna work out pretty benefit. Let's get out of here. Get to the other side. I want to avoid that laser as much as possible. Let's not focus on doing any damage. There we go. I can keep my distance away from him as the orbs are starting to, well, orbit. Keep my distance. I don't wanna get stuck inside that at all. Oh, that is beautiful. Get all the XP, please. Nice. That is the true test of this run to see if this is going to be beneficial because that boy there is super dangerous. And I've lost to him too many times. Crash damage dealt to be a burning enemy to cause Nova. Okay. Charge shot. Don't need it. Submission. War machine. Yeah, let's go ahead and just upgrade the turret while we have a chance. We can also upgrade the ally to an interceptor. Has weapon hits to ignite targets. Are ignited for 125% of the damage. Never mind. Let's go ahead and do that instead. Go ahead and deploy the turret down here on the side. He can fire missiles now. Ooh, quite a few missiles too. Surprised by how many there were. Cause you to rapidly fire weapon projectiles and a 360-degree radial spread when your shield breaks. Huh, that seems a little weird. Converse your drones into assault drones. Oh, I didn't get a chance to really read that. I just clicked on it to see if I could read it. But apparently my drones are now assault drones. Let's not get sucked in. Let's get to the other side of the map. That's not the other side of the map. Oh God, where am I? I'm still alive. I'm still alive. Oh, that was close. I was worried there. I thought I was boosting away from the black hole off to the side of the map, but I don't know what happened. I managed to still get sucked in and still survive. I think those guys are gonna charge us. There we go. I was super worried. I'm like, man, are we really gonna be able to beat that boss that we've died to so many times, but then just get sucked in by, just getting sucked in by the black hole? That would have been a very sad ending. That would have been a very sad ending. God damn it. God damn it. God, that was such a good run too. Oh, I am upset with myself. I can't dodge anything. I don't understand. When you have to face the direction in order to dodge anything, it takes so long to rotate and get out of the way. I didn't even realize I was being hit by that laser. I thought I was at the edge of its extension. Like, I keep expecting there to be like a more defined laser like definition to that, but apparently I was being hit the whole time. God damn it, that was such a good run too. Digities, I can guarantee you I will be revisiting this idea. If anything, it might even be the next episode, and it'll probably be a longer episode too, because at that point I'm not gonna stop until I can get at least kind of far in this game. Because I need to learn how to dodge. Apparently I don't know how to dodge. Like, I wasn't even aware I was taking damage. It's so hard to see with so many lasers and lights on the screen, you know? I'm just making excuses for myself at this point. I just have to get better at this game. But thank you, DigiDs. I'm still not sure how to do any of these outros, but I can guarantee I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.